Yukum guys, this is how to screen record on Windows using WinX Video AI. Download WinX Video AI, then install it. So the cool thing about WinX Video AI is that you got a image AI, which allows you to enhance your images. And then you got a video AI for video enhancement, then an audio AI for your audio enhancement and noise suppression. And then you got a video converter for your videos, and then a downloader so you can download videos all over the internet through different websites. And then you got the screen recorder inside WinX Videos. So you can do things like record your screen, you can annotate and draw on your screen recordings, or record your gameplay. You can even record your webcam with your screen or gameplay. So we're gonna click on recorder. So then it's gonna bring you to the interface of WinX Video AI. So it's asking for the desired recording mode. Go on screen. And what this is gonna do is actually output our screen. So you can see in the preview window over here, we got our whole screen showing up. So this is what it's showing up right now. And if you have multiple monitors, you can like go over here and change it to the other monitor. So you can click over here. So over here, you can select which audio device you wanna connect. And then over here is where your microphone sound is coming from. So you can like select your microphone and then it's gonna show something. So you can see that it's showing like a bar for me. So it's like real-time audio feedback over here. But you can also record your webcam. So if you go on our webcam option, you can then see our webcam is gonna start showing up right over here. So you can see I'm over here on my webcam settings, so you could just record it as it is. So if you have a green screen, then you're also able to remove your webcam background. So you want to go on remove webcam background and then go on the color value picker and then go on pick screen color and then go and pick a shade of green. So let's say I want to pick a middle one over here. So let's go over here and then click on OK after that. So you can see that it's got some spill showing and some noise. So we need to make some adjustments to it. So we need to like play around with the values until it's just right. So maybe, yeah, I think we're coming close, you guys. So after tuning the settings, I got it to remove the background like this. It's not perfect around the edges, but it definitely does the job over here. Then you got this other option, which is screen and webcam. So this is actually going to allow you to record your screen and webcam. So you got like an option says screen while showing face cam. So you can do your screen and then your face cam is gonna be like on the background. So you can actually adjust this and if you want to, so you can move it over here. It's up to you how you wanna move it. If you wanna adjust the size, you can adjust the size just like this and move it around where you want it. So I could have it around here, or I could move it around here. It's up to you how you want to do it. So here's an example of me playing my game and I got my webcam background removed. So it's actually doing a pretty decent job. And then you got the audio recording. So this only allows you to record your audio while you're doing your, you know, speech or something. Let's try recording our screen over here. And we actually adjust the settings. So go on settings. So for the recording settings over here, if you want to get the most out of your recordings, then set it to high. And then for the recording format, you want to just select MP4 because that's the most compatible one you can use. And then for the desktop audio, this is basically where your PC sounds coming from. So I'm just going to leave it as default, but you can pick it manually if you want to. And then you can adjust the audio levels of your PC and your mic audio. So this is actually the mic audio where your sound's coming from. Then we got the encoder over here. I always recommend you use hardware instead of software, unless you don't have the option for hardware. So I'm gonna pick NVENC. And then for the camera device, just choose your camera, like your webcam. So then you got like your hotkeys over here. So these hotkeys are pretty long, so if you guys want to like stop your recording and want something simple, then you can manually set it right there. So I'm just going to set mine to, let's say, F1. I'll just set mine to F1. And for the paint tools, basically this allows you to annotate and paint around your screen. So let's say I want to do F2 for that one. It's up to you which hotkey you want to do, but For me, I'm just gonna do it like this. Then you have the options to show mouse in the recording, which I'm gonna leave it on. And then you got like this option to show your mouse click in the recording. So this can be very handy when you're recording a lecture on your screen or something. And then you can show your keys in your recording. So you might want to emphasize a key combination or something like that. But I'm not going to keep any of these on because, you know, I don't prefer doing that. But it's up to you if you want to try it out. And then it says show countdown, which is something that normally counts down before you start recording. It's up to you if you want to keep that, but I'm just going to leave it on. And then we're gonna close it. And then now we are set to start recording. Okay, so now we're gonna do a test recording of our screen. So I'm gonna click on record. And then it's gonna give you like a countdown timer over here. Then we'll just do a test recording right here. Go on our like file browser. So I got my annotations hotkey set up. So you can see that I can actually draw over my desktop and I can undo it also. So if I want to draw a shape, let's say I want to highlight this part, I can do that. And this is actually very cool when you want to like use it for like lectures or you want to use it for educational or seminars or whatever. This can be a really cool feature. So let's say I want an arrow, I can have an arrow pointing there. And let's say I want like a text, I can like write something down. So I can write download folder or something like that. This is just giving you ideas of what you can do, but it's a really cool feature. And once you're done, then you can actually undo all this and then it should be all clean again. And then I'm gonna stop my recording. So if you guys want to record your game, then what you want to do is launch your game. So I got Minecraft over here. I'm gonna launch Minecraft. Then you need to go on WinX Video and then it's going to show you the preview with the game on. So I'm going to click on record, or you can actually crop it. So you can see part of the windows is showing up here. So what we can do is like crop the window. So we can actually just have the game portion show up only. So once you've done that, and then you should be able to just click on the tick button here. You can see it's only showing us our game. So then you can start recording your game and then just play your game like you normally do. You can actually test out your recording and see how that goes. So once you're done with that, then you actually just press the start button and then go on WinX Video. You can either use your hotkey to stop the recording so you don't need to go here every time, or just stop it manually like I'm doing. Then it should show you like the recording for this also. So if I click this over here, it's gonna bring you to where your recordings are. So I could actually play this off and show you guys. So this is the gameplay footage of Minecraft that we just recorded. So you can see we got a recorded footage of Minecraft using WinX Video AI, and I think it's pretty decent. So get the WinX Video AI now. Links in the description. And it's got many other features other than its screen recording that you will benefit from. So this is how to screen record on Windows using WinX Video AI. Please check out my other videos, like and subscribe, and have a Yoko Malicious day.